think this was once the Temple of Earth. Look what has become of it.
I've never set foot here either. Yet the change is clear.
Well, at least it seems the Eternian forces dare not deploy troops here.
Yet, I sense a foul presence.
Monsters, no doubt.
They may be after the Earth Crystal.
Let's hurry!
did!
Thank you.
see. It says, observations of the crystal, submitted by... What? Victor S. Court? Understand.
Yes, I'm afraid I didn't follow that either. It seems I must look beyond what I had thought was simple desecration of the crystal.
The healing waves emanating from the crystal. This one also reads, submitted by Victor S. Court. They truly wish to advance medicine.
That treatment Idea's mother was receiving must have resulted from this research.
How could have such worthy efforts gone so terribly wrong?
Interim report on alchemical life research. Oh, this one reads, submitted by Vincent S. Court.
Life? They went beyond merely saving lives?
Wait, there's more. This so-called alchemical life is unstable, and keeping the resulting subjects alive comes at great difficulty. So, it seems they propose that the research be shut down. An account by a crystallist of high standing. This is what the author wrote about the Great Plague.
Like a hero in the making. If he had counted among the Orthodoxy's leaders, this land would have perhaps changed for the better. But then perhaps I wouldn't have been here with you today.
The end of the world. The Reconquest of Eternia. I wonder what it says in here. The Reconquest Campaign. Troop deployments.
Thank you.
temple occupation. It says this one is written by Sir Argent Heinkel, commander. The occupation of the city. This one says it's written by Commander Sigma Kint.
No, Idea. Why should you repent for the sins of your father? Now, Let's get on with the Rite of Awakening.
What's that on the crystal?
That's Giga's Lich!
It's the propagator of doom as told of in the sacred texts of the Orthodoxy.
Well, whatever it is, here it comes!
First settled here. I refuse to believe this could be my father's doing.
For better or worse, I believe the Eternian forces would have guarded the crystal from such threats. Maybe it took advantage of their weakened state to slip in unnoticed.
Save your jabbering for later! We have a crystal to awaken! Okay, here goes. This is the fourth and final crystal. Make us proud, Agnes! What's wrong?
It's really nothing. But time and time again, the Duchy's people have warned us not to awaken the crystal.
Agnes!
I know. I ought not let it bother me. Now, let us begin, Eri.
Not yet! More! Keep going! Still not enough! You can do this! Stop! That's it! Hooray! We did it!
Holy smokes! That was by far the brightest of the four crystals.
Agnes, are you all right?
Yes. Thank you, Tiz.
Now all four of Luxendark's crystals have been awakened. Nice work, everyone.
What a joyous day. Now perhaps the world...
Is the Great Chasm gone?
Nuh-uh. Awakening all four crystals should have caused a pillar of light to rise somewhere in our world. It's the holy pillar, the first light, divine source of life and the origin of this world and the heavens above. Once I place my brooch within the holy pillar, the first light will spread across the world. And its divine light, born of the awakened crystals, will sweep away all darkness. And the great chasm should vanish along with the darkness.
So all we need to do is take you into the pillar of light. Then let's go! That is where this will all end.
Lead the way.
I'm with you.
Together we go.